Hello, welcome to Going Global. I'm your host, Chung Se-mi. World War II is remembered as one of the deadliest and the most tragic conflicts in human history. An estimated 50 million people were killed in the war. And this year, marking the 70th anniversary of the end of World War II, various commemoration events are taking place across Europe. Germany in particular has called it the country's liberation from the Nazis and apologized once again to Russia and other European countries for Nazi Germany's actions. These heartfelt apologies and acknowledgement of past crimes are one of the reasons why Germany has gained respect and trust from other countries around the world. And today we bring you a story from Germany. Now, Germany is a country closely connected to South Korea. The two share the same tragedy of a divided nation, and Korea has a lot to learn from Germany that is now a reunified country. Recently, a group of youth public diplomats from Korea visited Germany for a special 9-day trip. Let's join them now.
11 students born and raised in South Korea or North Korea have landed in Europe. Sponsored by the Overseas Koreans Foundation, they are the youth public diplomats who have come to Germany to learn something special. The beautiful Rhine River and the myth of Lorelei are great things to explore, but these students are here for another reason.
경제 발전에 도움을 주신 할머니와 할아버지들의 희생 정신을 본받고
우리나라 역사를 조금이라도 더 정확한 인식으로 알리면
War, division, economic development, and reunification that Korea has not yet achieved. Germany is a country that share a lot in common with Korea. So what will these young students full of dreams learn in Germany? Let's follow their special 9-day trip. This is the Solferine coal mine industrial complex in the city of Essen. Now left as a heritage site, it was where the world's largest coal mining facility stood. It was also the place where many young South Korean miners came to work and make their living more than 50 years ago. The first generation of these miners are recorded at the Memorial Hall for Korean Miners sent to Germany that was established 5 years ago. It's a rainy spring morning in Essen. The youth public diplomats have arrived at the Memorial Hall. They look excited to be meeting the actual people who worked as miners and nurses back then. Yun Heng-ja came to Germany in 1969 as a nurse and has been living here for more than half a century. She is moved to tears as she says it's the first time that students from Korea have visited her. Yoon came to Germany, leaving her two children behind in Korea. With a determination to reunite with her family, she even took on the work of cleaning dead bodies. Expressing her regrets for the strained inter-Korean relations, she describes the relationship between East Germany and West Germany. The actual mine cart that the first generation of Korean coal miners used is on display at the Memorial Hall. How did more than 10 adults get in this small cart when it's barely large enough for just one person? The students are surprised.
파독 광부나 간호사가 있었다는 사실만 알고 있었지 그분들의 정확한 생활이나 모습들에 대해서 잘 몰랐거든요. 근데 얘기를 듣고 나니까 되게 대단하다는 생각이 들었고 이분들의 하신 일들을 기억해야 되겠다는 생각이 들었어요.
Next, the students visit a history museum in Bonn, the former capital of West Germany. Germany was a divided country like Korea until 1990 when it was reunified. The museum illustrates how the country, after being separated into East Germany and West Germany for more than 40 years, attained reunification. The students absorb the pieces of German history one by one. What captures their attention the most is the Berlin Wall, which was a symbol of the divided Germany. It was just a piece of wall, but standing in front of it, it feels different.
사람들의 마음이 통일을 간절히 원하니까 콘크리트가 두껍지만 허물게 된 것 같아요.
한 민족으로서 똑같은 민족애로 이제 그런 사업적인 부분보다 문화적인 부분에 교류를 더 많이 해야 된다는 생각이 듭니다.
The experience is more meaningful for Kun Song, whose dream is to become a history teacher. He is a North Korean defector who settled in South Korea after fleeing from the North in 2010 and passing through China and Laos. More than anyone else, he is interested in Korean history and the problems of Korean reunification. But he says that nobody around him is interested, and some friends don't even want to see Korea reunified. He wants to share with his friends how important it is for the two Koreas to achieve peaceful reunification, something he learned in Germany.
통일 교육할 때 필수로 독일 예로 들거든요, 학교에서. 근데 그 예를 여기 와서 미흡한 부분이라 해야 되나? 거기서 얘기하지 못한 부분을 여기서 체험으로 한번 알아봤고요. 그다음에 나중에는 그 저의 친구들한테도요. 통일에 큰 관심을 가지게 할 수가 있다면 저도 이런 경험을 조금 추천하고요.
Students get to meet Koreans living in Germany. The youth public diplomats were invited to join a camp where students from 17 Korean schools in Germany learn the Korean language and Korean culture. They enter the dormitories with excitement at the thought of meeting new friends. The youngest of the group, Seung-hwan, quickly found his room.
아, 2007년생이요.
네.
아, 저러요. 아, 친구 안녕하세요. 아, 안녕하세요. 안녕, 안녕,
안녕. No matter where these teens are from, they all struggle to master jigi-jagi, a Korean folk game. It's a lot more fun to play with hands instead. As they start to play dodgeball, their voices get louder. The ice is broken, and now they are busy cheering for their team.
(목소리도) 청소년들을 저희 또래 애들 만나서 같이 교류하는 그런 기회가 돼서 엄청 기뻤던 것 같아요.
교포들이랑 한국에서 온 애들이 같이 일하는 게 딱 이제 오늘 게임하면서 팀워크가 잘 되는 게 보여졌거든요. 그래서 그게 좋았던 것 같아요.
The students from Korea also help their friends carry out a debate in Korean. The topic is whether it's better to be rich young or rich old. As the students debate over the issue, some interesting questions and answers cross over.
근데 늙었을 때는 그게 약간 늙었고 힘도 없고 그러니까 그때 차라리 돈을 그렇게 많은 게.
사랑 has a German father. Although she's only 12 this year, she has some witty answers.
사랑의 힘으로 산다고 했잖아요.
네.
근데 그 나이 때 되면 그냥 정으로 사는 건데.
네, 네, 네.
She looks more like a Westerner, but Sarang considers herself a Korean and loves to learn the Korean language.
말하는 거 그리고 발음 뭐 이런 것도 다르고 저희가 좀 되게 그래도 어느 정도 잘한다고 생각했는데 그래도 한국인은 한국인인 것 같아요. 그래서
Time flies by too fast for these students. The 5-day camp has brought them very close to each other. Junpyo was the one who kept the mood lively during the camp. He hands a small farewell gift to Yudok, who is from the city of Augsburg.
이거는 내 사는 지역의 책자고.
와. 휴대폰?
휴대폰을 고치는 거. 전자파. 이거 방지하는 거고. 이거는 인형.
고마워.
앞으로도 이거 보고 이번에 우리 그 했던 거 생각하면서 재밌게 살아 앞으로도.
Although they say their goodbyes now, they can still keep in touch over the internet. They are not sad to part. Instead, they look at the future ahead of them.
비록 그 한국 언니 오빠들 못 보지만 그래도 다음에 다시 올 거예요. 그러니까 너무 재밌었어요.
저랑 다른 환경에서 살아온 친구들이잖아요. 그런 친구들하고 얘기하면서 더 많은 인생을 경험한 것 같아서 너무 좋았고 앞으로도 계속 연락 유지하면서 그렇게 살았으면 좋겠습니다.
After the camp with overseas Koreans, the youth public diplomats are heading out to take part in another special activity. This is Cologne Cathedral, which has been under construction for more than 600 years. Over 6 million tourists visit this World Heritage Site every year, and the students are performing a Dokdo flash mob in front of it. Tourists who have been watching them get excited too and follow their dance moves.
Dokdo가 우리 땅이라는 걸 알릴 수 있을 것 같고 여기 이렇게 이런 활동을 많이 하면 많은 외국인들이 관심을 가질 것 같아요.
This is Frankfurt, the financial capital of Germany that's located on the downstream side of the Main River. The students are visiting the Consulate General of the Republic of Korea in Frankfurt for the day. It feels a little different and special to see the taegukgi flying in the wind so far from Korea. The students can't believe it's already their last program in Germany. It seems only like yesterday that they arrived here. They're meeting up with the incumbent diplomat. During an hour-long Q&A session, the students ask questions based on their experiences over the past few days.
과거 서동독보다 상황이 열악하고 좋지 않다고 저는 개인적으로 생각을 하거든요. 이런 상황에서 통일을 어떻게 준비해 나가는 것이 좋은 방법인지.
우리가 되려면 우리가 튼튼해야 돼. 그러려면 다 자기를 충실히 하고 자기를 열심히 해서 자기가 튼튼하면은 우리 국가가 튼튼해져.
Listening attentively, the students look more mature than they did when they first arrived in Germany. Nine days passed as if in a dream. By meeting the past and present of overseas Koreans, the students learned about another part of Korean history that continues in Germany. They could also picture a reunified Korean peninsula as they experienced a reunified Germany.
또 세계를 볼 수 있는 게 넓어진 것 같아요.
다른 나라에 있지만 다 한국인이라는 그게 되게 신기했어요.
공공 외교에 대해서 뭔가 좀 조금 도움 준 것 같아서 뿌듯한 것도 있고.
South Korea and North Korea, Korea and Germany. Although the students were born and grew up in different backgrounds, they were brought together by their identity. They are Korean. And the dream of a reunified Korea is probably already on its way of coming true.
It was deeply moving to see young students from South Korea and North Korea visit Germany together. Hopefully, there will come a day when the two Koreas become one and all the people can meet each other freely on their own land. Today on Going Global, we brought you a story full of hopes for a reunified Korea, and I hope you enjoyed it. May is called the Family Month in Korea, and for that, there are many occasions for exchanging gifts. And this year, I gave my parents red ginseng products on Parents' Day. They're very popular in Korea, and surprisingly, their popularity is growing overseas, especially in the United States. Thanks to the positive health effects of red ginseng, the number of Americans consuming red ginseng is on the rise. And since Korean red ginseng products are recognized for its excellence and credibility in the United States, they're sold 10 times more expensive than the Chinese products. It'd be nice if more people around the world can benefit from Korean red ginseng goods. Going Global will be back next week with more interesting stories. Thank you for watching.